ladies and gentlemen, KJ here, and I would like to welcome you back to another episode of the NWL. We have a great night of action here for you once again, ladies and gentlemen, coming off of our huge CPV SummerSlam. It was a great night of action, and there is going to be a lot of repercussions this week, next week, and the coming weeks as we build up towards our next CPV Extreme Rules. That one's going to be even more fun with the match stipulations we will be having. Anyway, tonight in our main event, it is going to be a No Disqualifications match between Randy Orton and Ted DiBiase. Their issues with each other are not over yet. They're going to go at it once again here tonight. That's going to be a fun match to watch. But first up, we have none other than Seth Rollins taking on Hiroshi Nakamoto. So here we go, guys. One-on-one competition between Seth Rollins and Hiroshi Nakamoto. I'm looking forward to this match. It's going to be a great one between these two. Clashing of styles here. The technical wrestling and a little bit of a high-flying style of Seth Rollins versus the submission and Japanese-infused style of Hiroshi Nakamoto is going to make for an instant classic between these guys. And it's going to be a huge, huge match for Hiroshi here. If he can somehow pull out the victory over Seth Rollins, that would give him a huge amount of momentum moving forward. Just like Seth Rollins currently has a huge amount of momentum right now. Going for a possible pin there, but way too early as Hiroshi's able to kick out of it. And comes flying at him with a kick right to the gut. Follows it up with another one there. Seth Rollins right now, as I said, huge amount of momentum, especially after this past Sunday at SummerSlam. He faced off against the Icon Sting in one-on-one contest, and he was able to come out on top, beating the Stinger. A classic match by both superstars. Nothing to be ashamed of by Sting losing that match. It was a great one. No doubt going to be one of the top matches of the year this year. Might be number one as it is already. They put on a classic. No title was involved, but there didn't have to be one. Just a lot of bad blood between them. as Seth Rollins has basically said since coming into the NWL here, that this is now the Seth Rollins era, and he is making this show watchable again. I'd like to think that was watchable before he came, but it no doubt got a lot more interesting with him being here now. It's even more interesting when he beats a two-time former NWL champion. Gives him a lot of momentum and a lot of clout here in the locker room. Now he's going up against a guy like Hiroshi Nakamoto, looking to make a name for himself as well. He's been here a year. Seth Rollins only half a year, but he's already eclipsed what Nakamoto has done. So we're going to have to see if Hiroshi can somehow make a name for himself in this one by beating Seth Rollins. Not looking too good right now as Rollins seems to have control of this match. Going at him with a couple kicks right there, but Hiroshi's able to reverse it. Working on the arm a little bit there. Not probably the body part you should be focusing on with Seth Rollins. You should instead be trying to weaken up his legs, especially with that very dangerous curb stomp that he utilizes. Can hit that almost out of nowhere. Just a quick kick to the gut, or his opponent getting up off the ground and boom, foot to the back of the head, face to the mat, and you are out of it. No chance of anyone kicking out yet. I don't know if anyone's gonna ever be able to kick out of that one. Seth Rollins continuing to control Hiroshi right now, delivering a knee to the face. Now got him caught in the corner, up to the second rope. Seth Rollins comes flying through with a powerbomb. Nice dropkick there to Hiroshi, putting him down on the mat, and Rollins now going off a springboard, just barely getting a piece of Hiroshi there. But it's okay, because a moonsault attempt there by Seth Rollins goes for the pin, looking to put away Hiroshi in this one, but only gets a one count. Hiroshi Nakamoto no doubt has a lot of pride in his wrestling and himself, and is not going to go down without a fight against Seth Rollins here, as he's going for a possible crossbody, but I think he might have missed that thing. Instead, he's going for now a submission on Hiroshi, who's able to easily break out of it. Hiroshi's going to fight basically to the end right now against Seth Rollins and do everything he possibly can to try to gain the victory. It's a little odd, though, I gotta say. Usually Hiroshi's out here with one of his new crew teammates as a manager, but this time he's taking it by himself. Of course, El Generico, one of his teammates, got thoroughly dismantled at SummerSlam last Sunday by Mr. Money in the Bank Agent Smith. Very dominant performance by Agent Smith against El Generico, so that might be the reason why he's not out here to support Hiroshi in this one. Could no doubt use all the help he can get against someone like Seth Rollins, who remains in control of this match with a dropkick to the seated Hiroshi there. Hiroshi's hit a couple moves, built up a little bit of momentum, but has not been able to sustain it so far in this one. And that's a key to this match. He really does need to sustain some momentum against Seth Rollins, because otherwise it is not going to be in your favor when that bell rings at the end. You're probably going to be ending up on the ground, possibly looking up at the ceiling, wondering what the hell went wrong. Seth Rollins delivering a knee to the chest of Hiroshi. You can see the battle wounds are already starting to show for the Japanese superstars. Seth Rollins takes him down with a drop toe hold. Now going for a submission possibly here. Oh, surfboard. Surfboard by Seth Rollins to Hiroshi. You can see the pain and anguish in the face of Hiroshi right there. Then some chops So Hiroshi came running right into it. Seth Rollins now taking his time and enjoying this part of the experience. So Hiroshi is on unsteady feet, and Seth Rollins is currently taking control of that, dropping him on the small of his back. Gotta find a way to try to come back in this one, Hiroshi, but instead Seth Rollins, oh, beautiful reversal instead. Rollins was no doubt looking for that powerbomb into the corner, and Hiroshi Nakamoto, beautiful reversal. Let's see if that can maybe give him a little bit of momentum and get him going in this match. He really needs something, and that could have been that thing that he needed most. Seth Rollins is kind of stunned right now. A little bit thrown off his game. He's got to try to capitalize on this. Rollins with the headlock. Now taking him down with a necklock there. And this could be bad. This could be bad. Rollins is getting in that place. Kick to the gut. This is what I was talking about earlier. Curb stomp. A curb stomp by Seth Rollins to Hiroshi Nakamoto. Now going for the pin. Is Hiroshi done? Yes, he is. Dominant performance there by Seth Rollins. Hiroshi had a couple bright spots in that match, a couple times that you thought maybe he could get going, get a little bit of momentum, string together some offense, but instead the cunning Seth Rollins stifled him out at every turn and was able to finally hit the curb stomp to end the match and gain the victory.
You think you know?
So here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Tag team action in this one as Edge and Christian facing off against Cowboy Keith and Wade Barrett. It's going to be a good match between these two competitors. These two teams, a lot of pride they have, but one of them is going to have to lose in this one. Edge and Christian, of course, the veteran tag team, been together many years, won many championships outside the NWL, and are no doubt looking to gain some traction and possibly win one here in the NWL. Meanwhile, Cowboy Keith and Wade Barrett are a relatively new tag team here. They're looking to make a name for themselves, and they could possibly do that at the expense of Edge and Christian here tonight. Recently, Keith and Barrett have taken out the Chosen Ones, former NWL Tag Team Champions. However, they did lose to Edge and Christian about 3-4 weeks ago, so this is a rematch between these two teams, looking to avenge that loss and prove that they are better than they were that night. Really didn't look that good, really kind of looked off a little bit, not themselves. So hoping for a better performance here tonight than back then. Cowboy Keith slamming down Edge and then delivering a dropkick to the seated one. Now off the ropes, Cowboy Keith dropping the elbow. He'll tag in Wade Barrett, the British brawler. Enjoys using his punches to great efficiency. Edge luring him into the corner. And now double team tagging in Christian as they take out Wade Barrett. Christian now taking out Cowboy Keith on the outside. That distracted him a little bit and allowed Barrett to gain position on him. Christian, of course, a newcomer to the NWL. Recently showed up at WrestleMania and signed on with us, especially after his buddy Edge was getting attacked by Corey Mills after a match. Showed up, helped him out, and ever since then they have been a very successful team. Although Edge himself has been a part of many successful teams. Former NWL Tag Team Champion with Randy Orton as a part of Rated RKO. Suffered a couple injuries that knocked him out of action and cost him the titles eventually. But now he is hoping to regain those titles with his new partner, Christian. Meanwhile, on the other side of things, Cowboy Keith is a former champion, former NWL champion, first ever NWL champion. Barrett has yet to hold anything, except Christian, who he lowers down on top of his knee for a backbreaker there. Throws him with force into the turnbuckle, comes back. But Christian is able to reverse it into a knee to the gut, only to land on Barrett's knee in a very uncomfortable position. Wade Barrett now lifting up Christian, delivering a gutbuster across his knee. Now getting up on top of him and raining down the punches. Already I can tell you Wade Barrett and Cowboy Keith are looking a lot better in this match than they did a couple weeks ago. Showing a lot more aggressiveness and will to win this matchup. After that match, they went out and then just basically took apart the Chosen Ones the following week. They're getting their minds reset on what they want, and obviously what they want is to be one of the best tag teams in this division here. And I believe that they could do it. They have all that they need to. Christian gets thrown into the corner turnbuckle. Wade Barrett delivering a clothesline out of it, nearly taking Christian's head off in the process, and he will tag in Cowboy Keith. Keith will now get to go to work on the woozy Christian. Picks him up and tosses him down. A sack of potatoes right there. Keith is in complete control right now. Christian really needs to make a tag, get Edge into this match. Because currently, you can see he is showing the signs of this battle. A little worse for wear as Cowboy Keith showing off right now. Edge not taking it very lightly. Going after Christian, but he's able to reverse it. But not the second time, as that time he does hit the backbreaker off the ropes. Once again, dropping the elbow to Christian. He has been completely and utterly isolated from his teammate right now. That is not something he needs. There you go, an opening that could be what Christian needs, and he tags in Edge. High knee to Cowboy Keith gives him the advantage in this one. Is now Edge is feeling the brunt of Cowboy Keith's offense. Dropping an elbow to the chest as Edge does not seem to be faring much better right now against Keith. He's taking him, throwing him into the ropes. They get caught up together, but Wade Barrett, nice punch there. Distracts Edge and allows Cowboy Keith to capitalize. Tagging in Barrett now, who will go to work on the Rated R Superstar. He needs to get something going. He needs to pick up the pace here. Get maybe a big move or two going. Something, because right now, Cowboy Keith and Wade Barrett have control of this match, and they are not looking to let up anytime soon. Dropped right once again in the nether regions. And there's a wasteland. Wasteland by Wade Barrett could be gaining the victory here, but ref didn't even count. Looked like he was distracted. I don't know if that was Christian that he was talking to or maybe Cowboy Keith, but didn't even start a count there. That allowed Edge to get out of that thing relatively quick. Could have possibly saved the match for Edge and Christian. You can see the ref now talking to Christian. Obviously, it was him that was distracting him. Not something that Edge and Christian do all the time, but they needed to do it this time to preserve that match. Edge now fighting out of a submission by Wade Barrett, who delivers a bulldog. Still in complete control of this match. Edge trying to fight back with a kick, but Wade Barrett reverses it. Throws him into his turnbuckle, and then delivers a big boot. Going after Christian, who wisely gets out of the way there. Edge then gets thrown down to the mat with the assistance of gravity. Now he's being thrown into the turnbuckle. Cowboy Keith being tagged in, double team here. Keith goes flying with the crossbody, assisted by Wade Barrett. Once again, another backbreaker. This time, Cowboy Keith fired up, ready to go, could be looking to put away. Edge has him up on his shoulder, and this time a wasteland by Cowboy Keith, looking for the pin. The victory is in reach, and they get it. A very dominant performance this time by Cowboy Keith and Wade Barrett, after being kind of humiliated and defeated by Edge and Christian last time. They come back fighting and swinging and utterly dominating them on their way to another victory in the tag team ranks. So a very impressive match right there between Cowboy Keith, Wade Barrett, and Edge and Christian. Congratulations to Barrett and Keith gaining the victory over ENC. We'll see if this momentum that they've been building up recently can go anywhere for them. We're going to go ahead, though, and move on to our next match. You saw him verbally sparring with Seth Rollins earlier in the night. Now he's going to be physically sparring with Corey Mills in this one. Steve Smooth and Corey Mills, singles action right now.
Thank you.
here we go. Corey Mills and Steve Smooth, one-on-one action. This is the first time we've seen Steve Smooth in action in quite a while now. He successfully defended his NWL Intercontinental Championship at Money in the Bank against CM Punk. Since then, we really haven't seen much of him. He was not on the SummerSlam card. Took a little bit of time out, rested up, and is ready to go once again here. And he better be, because this is against Corey Mills here. The Surfer Dude is a very dangerous competitor. Always got to watch out for him. Can always try to find a way to come out on top. And this is going to be a great matchup, no doubt, between these two. I got to say that when these two first signed with the NWL last year, and when I first saw these two in the ring, I was really, really excited and really hoping for a match between these two one-on-one some point down the line. I think they both have a great, bright future here in the NWL. Corey Mills is a little bit cocky, a little bit uses his mouth too much and thinks that he's better than everyone else. Kind of gets him in trouble at times. But Steve Smooth has a little bit of that in him too, but he's been able to back it up so far with winning the Intercontinental Championship at WrestleMania this past year. He's held on to it since then, a very dominant champion. He is willing to speak his mind and open his mouth, especially against someone like Seth Rollins earlier in the night. So far, he's been able to back it up when he does the talking. Beautiful, beautiful move right there as it sends Corey Mills flying across the ring. Once there, you saw it, Steve Smooth saying to Corey Mills, "You're going to stay down this one. I'm going to make sure of it." Mills, though, now going for an armbar too close to the ropes as Steve Smooth is able to get his feet on there and break it up. Mills is going to go right back at him, slinging some punches his way, but instead some kicks by Steve Smooth land right on the chest and stomach region. Two of them kind of separate and then come back together in the center of the ring. Once again, going after the arm there. Nice high knee to the face. Gonna be very dangerous for both of these guys to be delivering knees to each other. Neither one wear knee pads, so it's just bone on bone when they land it. Nice elbow drop right to the heart by Steve Smooth. Corey Mills, though, is able to catch him the second time. And now going to try to go to work on him. Instead gets a kick to the gut, and Steve Smooth off the ropes, hitting his patent scissors kick, putting Corey Mills down on the ground and showing off for the crowd as only Steve Smooth can. The gyration of the hips, beautiful German suplex throw, and once again showing off before Corey Mills makes him pay. Back and forth action right now by these two. They're both very talented, both very willing to do whatever it takes to gain a victory in this match. Corey Mills especially probably wants to win. It's the NWL Intercontinental Champion he's facing off against. A win against him will no doubt put him towards the front of the line for a title match. Be a very interesting Intercontinental Champion. Would run his mouth a lot. But I could also see it ending fairly quickly when he runs it off to someone a little bit bigger and better than him. Going for a pin now on Steve Smooth, who's just barely able to get his shoulders up there at 2.5. Corey Mills could be looking to put away Steve Smooth now as he takes him out with a neckbreaker, picking him back up. Steve Smooth, though, wisely elbowing his way out of this one, comes running in and puts him down with an atomic drop. Corey Mills has shifted the momentum into his favor in this match right now. Like I said, big opportunity for him to beat the NWL Intercontinental Champion. Put him towards the top of the list for those to get a championship match. After all, CM Punk's kind of moved back down the list after being beaten. Agent Smith is now Mr. Money in the Bank. holding that briefcase. Got a chance at the NWL champion. So the field is no doubt wide open right now for challengers to Steve Smooth. Corey Mills with the win will put his name right towards the top. Steve Smooth going to do anything and everything he possibly can to prevent that from happening in this match. Delivering another elbow to the heart. With a little bit of theatrics at the beginning. And now rolling through, slamming him down the mat. Smooth has regained control of this one. Looking to hopefully put away Corey Mills in it. Picking him up, but Corey Mills, quick rake to the eyes, gives him control once again. Ooh, wow, kicks and punches galore by Steve Smooth. As he sends Corey Mills to the outside, the action will spill out there now. Referee has started his count. Steve Smooth delivering an elbow to the face of Corey Mills, who then decides to toss Steve Smooth back into the ring. Can't win this thing on the outside, and Corey Mills knows it. So he's going to bring him back in and hope to finish him up inside the ring instead. Oh, beautiful move there. Comes running into the turnbuckle, catches Steve Smooth. Mills regaining control this match. Needs that one big move, I feel like. That one big move puts Steve Smooth down and out in this one. Instead, Steve Smooth now catches Corey Mills, and that's the Smooth solution. A Smooth solution to the problem of Corey Mills right here, as Steve Smooth gains the victory. Great match by these two competitors, as Corey Mills has an excellent opportunity to try and put his name on the top of the list for those to challenge Steve Smooth, but instead, the rest and relaxation that Smooth has gotten over the past month has paid dividends, as he comes out ready to fight in this one, and he gains the victory over the Surfer Dude with a Smooth solution. Steve Smooth now celebrating his victory over Corey Mills, and oh no, 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 it's Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins coming out here and attacking Steve Smooth after his match with Corey Mills. He picked his spot and is making a statement. So Seth Rollins picked his spot and took out Steve Smooth right there, proving him right when he called him spineless earlier tonight. It's going to be interesting to see where this one goes between the two of these guys, especially if Steve Smooth gets the match against Seth Rollins he wants. Can Rollins stand toe-to-toe with the Intercontinental Champion? We might be finding out sooner than you think. However, guys, it is now time for our main event, and it is going to be a good one. It is a no disqualification match between Randy Orton and Ted DiBiase. We are looking to hopefully settle the differences they have between each other here tonight, although that might be wishful thinking because there is a lot of them between them. Ted DiBiase tried to take Orton out of action by slamming his head into a concrete wall. Orton is no doubt looking to do the same to him here tonight in the main event. Let's not waste any more time, guys. Let's go ahead and get it started right now. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen. It is main event time in the NWL, and it is going to be a dangerous one between these two superstars. No disqualification, no countout. It is just first person to get pinfall or submission in this one, or beats the living hell out of each other till they can't respond to the referee anymore, I should say. Hell, if someone gets knocked out, there's no doubt that this match is going to be over really fast, and these two superstars might be angling for that option instead of the other two. Randy Orton and Ted DiBiase have had their issues with each other in the past, and it has only gotten worse over the past couple weeks. I said it before, Ted DiBiase and Randy Orton had a brawl backstage a couple weeks ago. It ended when DiBiase smashed Orton's head into a concrete wall. Orton did turn out to be okay. He was able to compete this past Sunday and successfully defend the NWL Tag Team Championships. DiBiase, though, kind of sacrificed Cody Rhodes in that match. He came out of it relatively unscathed, which led to this match between these two. Their feud is not over, and they are going to try to beat the living hell out of each other right here tonight for our entertainment. What more could you ask for, guys? As they are going to do anything and everything to gain revenge and retribution on each other. Ted DiBiase has shown a little bit of a more aggressive, dangerous side to him, especially with slamming Orton's head into the concrete wall. He used the steel steps the following week on his partner Triple H, getting himself disqualified in the process, but he really didn't even care at that point. It was basically about hurting them and knocking them out of commission. Didn't do that, but still a very aggressive new side of Ted DiBiase we are seeing recently. I don't know if I really like it or not. I mean, it's great to see someone show a new side of themselves, be a little bit more aggressive, be trying to win championships and matches, but you cross a line when you're trying to actually hurt someone like it looks like Ted DiBiase is trying to do to Evolution right now. Randy Orton, though, no doubt is going to be trying to hurt DiBiase tonight, so I don't know if I should be rooting for either one of these guys. Orton, yeah, he's going to be looking for revenge, and yeah, DiBiase might have it coming a little bit right now, but still, if you're going to try to knock someone out of commission and hurt them in a match, that's just wrong on a couple different levels. And I don't know if I can support anyone who would do something like that. DiBiase kind of just going at Randy Orton with a bunch of punches right now. Punches and kicks, not being very technical with his wrestling abilities. This really isn't too much of a technical wrestling match. It's more, again, no disqualifications. You can do anything and everything. I'm surprised that we haven't gotten any weapons introduced into this thing. Some steel chairs, steel steps. We still might. Not gonna put it past these guys to use those. After all, DiBiase did use the steel steps on, like I said, on Triple H. Got himself disqualified. If he uses it this time, though, there's no rules against it. It's all legal. Sends Randy Orton to the outside right in front of our announce table here. Not especially what I want to have these guys bouncing around the announce table in a no disqualifications match, but comes with the job, I guess, is DiBiase slamming the knee of Orton down into the thinly padded floor there. Backbreaker as well over the knee. Orton could be in trouble here, but he's able to reverse DiBiase and then go sending him over the steel steps. That's the way you do it. That's the way Randy Orton gets a little bit of revenge in this one. Now they're right beside our table. This is not a good place for me, I gotta say. I'm thinking about myself and my own safety and well-being. I do not appreciate these guys being this close to me. Can you maybe move it back towards the ring and into the ring? After all, you can only win this match in that ring. So Move off. Thank you. Thank you. Ooh, bouncing his head off the steel post. Randy Orton now getting back into the ring and showing off to the crowd. It's Ted DiBiase getting back up and hanging up Orton on the top rope. Up, there we go. Steel steps could be coming into play here as Ted DiBiase brings him into the ring. Bad intentions he has on his mind right now against Randy Orton in this one. Orton, though, is able to knock the legs out from underneath to hit DiBiase, get him on the mat, and try to keep him grounded in this one, not allow him to get back to a vertical base and use those steel steps against you. That would be the smartest course of action right now. Instead, if Randy Orton wants to, he could instead be using the steel steps himself. Is DiBiase now lifting them up, going to be bringing them into play in this one, but Randy Orton kicks him in the chest, not allowing him to do it. Steel steps go flying, and Orton regains control of this match. Grabbing hold of the arm, targeting it a little bit in this one. Picking up Ted DiBiase and slamming him down on the mat. Randy Orton looking to make Ted DiBiase pay. Going for a possible RKO, but instead Ted DiBiase is able to reverse it. Beautiful job by Ted DiBiase reversing an RKO that was no doubt coming his way. Right in the center of the ring it would have been too. DiBiase now rolling out of the ring, looking for a chance to regroup in this one against Orton. Might not get that opportunity though, as Orton followed him outside. DiBiase though bringing a steel chair into the mix and using it. Ted DiBiase using the steel chair on Randy Orton, swinging for the fences as he's cracked him with it four times now, eventually throwing it down. DiBiase, oh, beautiful reversal. Randy Orton saw DiBiase going for the possible spine buster there and instead reversed it into a DDT and then a neck breaker. I think both of those, DiBiase landed on that steel chair that's on the outside there. Can't really see a lot of what's going on because they're on the other side of the ring. But yeah, I think DiBiase landed a couple times on that steel chair and that's not going to feel good. DiBiase, you can see he's starting to hold at his head. DDT once again by Orton, targeting that head. That is what DiBiase targeted on Orton, the head. And Orton, a little bit of payback in this one against DiBiase. Dragging him now to the center of the ring. Going for the pin. DiBiase could be in trouble here. This could be it. Is it? Yes. Randy Orton has put Ted DiBiase away in this one. A very dominant performance by Randy Orton. A very brutal performance by both these competitors. DiBiase using the steel chair a couple times and then Randy Orton DDT in his head on both the chair and thinly padded floor. And I think that's what pretty much knocked DiBiase out of this one. Congratulations to Randy Orton getting his retribution. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is all the action we have for you once again here tonight. Congratulations to Randy Orton getting his revenge and retribution on Ted DiBiase. He is no doubt going to be needing some ice, some Tylenol to deal with that splintering headache he probably is going to be suffering over the next couple days, as well as maybe some double vision. Take a lot of damage to your head, especially when you deal it out to others. It's what we call karma here in the wrestling business. Also, Seth Rollins making a statement to Steve Smooth, attacking him after a match and proving Smooth right when he said he was spineless. We're going to have to see where this one goes between these two. I'm looking forward, though, to next week, guys. I hope you guys are as well. Both Spider-Man and Carnage will be in the arena. It's going to get really, really interesting between these guys, especially after their controversial match at SummerSlam this past Sunday. I wouldn't want to miss it, and I hope you guys don't either. If you enjoyed this episode, though, guys, please go ahead and leave a like, as well as any comments you may have down below. Otherwise, I'm KJ. and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.